Today, as we know, is the day of National Candy Day. A day when kids across the world, well, not the world, kids across the country, well, not the whole country, you know, a lot of kids, a lot of people go to people's houses and they beg for candy, basically. What if I told you there was an easier way to get candy? What if I told you that for a certain amount of people, instead of going and degrading yourself begging for candy on National Candy Day or whatever its real name is, what if I told you you could earn your candy? What if I told you that there was a chance that out of three people, one of them would be able to receive exclusive candy in 3 to 4 business days? Well, that chance is here today. Inshallah, on today's program, we'll be playing a game called Kahoot. The game we'll be playing, we're going to be asking different questions from the Holy Quran and Islamic questions, and a total of 8 questions, and we have 3 contestants. Whoever answers the most questions out of those will be the winner of this game. And inshallah, they will receive, the winner will receive a good amount of candy to last them from here until the next imam's birthday. So, starting us off, here are our contestants. We have, in first place, the Invisible Man. Number 2, we have Dracula. I want to suck your blood. And in third place, we have Pumpkin Boy, or I forgot the third guy's name. It's not catchy. The Mummy, something like that. Yeah, one of those lesser known guys, you know. Okay, so inshallah, we'll be starting our questions soon. And let's start up the game. Now, here we go. Our first question of the program. The question is, how many times is the word birds mentioned in the Holy Quran? A4, B2, C18, or D7? Now, you will have a chance to answer. And so far, we have. Now, those are the options. So let's see what everybody else answered. Let's see. Somebody put the answer as 2. No, my friend, that is not correct. Now, these 3 people are anonymous. We don't know who these guys are. But let's just say that one of them will be very lucky. Inshallah, of course. If they do happen to receive that candy, you'll definitely be lucky. Of course, like I mentioned, only one person can win out of a total of 3 contestants. The next question. According to the Holy Quran, which bird buried Habil? An eagle? A chickadee? A sparrow? Or a crow? Okay. The answer was a crow. A crow was the bird that in the Holy Quran mentioned buried Habil. You know, I thought it also could be the sparrow, you know, the lucky sparrow, but of course, it's the crow. Next question. Which bird has 7 colors? Tanager, parakeet, turtle dove, or violet crow? And we have the mummy. His is doing considerably well. Not too well that they should be celebrating, but they were putting themselves in a favorable position, let's see. Meanwhile, the Invisible Man, got to catch up there, buddy. Say the Invisible Man is having a very spooky Halloween. Which bird lays the biggest eggs? Okay, so far we have the Invisible Man at 1,570 points. There are only 4 questions remaining. 4 questions remaining. Next question. Hudhud in Arabic refers to which type of bird? A. Blue jay, B. Hoopoe, C. Ostrich, or D. Kiwi? So far we got a close race here as we come down to the remaining 3 questions. Next question. Prophet Suleiman sends a hoopoe bird to deliver a message to whom? A. Queen Sheba, B. Queen Bilqis, C. Queen Elizabeth, or D. Cleopatra? Now, you know, this is a closed question. Close race so far, with 2 questions remaining. Now, if you don't win, you should be very sad, I would say. Which of these birds cannot fly? A. Hoopoe bird, B. White stork, D. Takahi, or D. Blue jay? The answer is C. A Takahi. Now, if whoever answered stork, you know, the stork, we know they can fly. If you saw the Storks movie, you'd understand, you know, when they deliver the babies, Next question. The last question. Which bird has the largest wingspan? A. Wandering albatross, B. A pelican, C. A white stork, or D. Indian condor? And the winner is the Invisible Man! Alhamdulillah. Oh, well, the Invisible Man did not win. It was, in fact, the Mummy! The Mummy is the winner of today's program. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them reward and give them the capacity to eat all of the candy that they are about to be delivered. The Mummy is the winner of this candy. We'd like to thank the Mummy for participating in this game. And of course, letting them know that all your delicious candy will be delivered to your house in 4 to 5 business days, depending on the postage. Now, of course, today's questions were based on the birds and the Holy Quran. Next week, inshallah, our next program will also be a different set of questions. Will be a different type of... will be a different set of stuff. So be prepared for that. It could be anything. So inshallah, we hope to do these to get more in touch with the Quran and to understand more. And of course, while we're doing that, it doesn't hurt to get a lot of free candy. So while everybody else is out begging for candy, wearing different costumes and putting plastic on their faces and, you know, looking like... you know what I mean, you know? Instead of doing that, why not get candy for free while learning about the Holy Quran? Inshallah, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to do this. And continuing the long run, we've had this for a couple years now. We used to have a program at Masjid Imam Ali, which is a center in California. It used to be located in Pleasanton, inshallah, now in Tracy, California. And what happened was, you know, we would all come and, you know, answer these questions. Answer questions, and of course, whoever answered the questions received candy. And this is a way, you know, get people inside of the masjid. So inshallah, we hope to do this type of program. And of course, now we only had our 3 contestants. These were 3 randomly selected people. And of course, the Mummy came out on top, getting some sweet candy. If you'd like to sign up for next program, inshallah, next program, you can sign up. Maybe we'll add a couple more program next time, and we'll try to have different prizes for next program. Well, that's all the time we have left for today. Thank you to our participants in the program. The Invisible Man, you'll get him next time. The Mummy, nice job. Dracula. Bit disappointed. Maybe next time. But that's all the time we've left today. Now we're going to do Allahumma kulli malika for the safety and protection of our Tawaf Imam. And inshallah, we're all helpers of our Tawaf Imam. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma kulli malika al-Hujjat ibn al-Hasan. Salawatuka alayhi wa ala bahi. Fi hadhihi as-sa'a wa fi kulli as-sa'a. Waliyan wa hafidha. وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد وشرجم